Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. Sometimes when you're working with a probability distribution, you'll be asked to find the mean, variance, or standard deviation. And so I have the formulas here for you to see, but I'm not really using these because I'm going to use my calculator or StatCrunch when I do these. And I have a nice video about how to do that in StatCrunch. So for my students that have access to Pearson, you have access to StatCrunch, and so that's the easiest way to find those values. But I just wanted to explain the formula. So the summation, the capital sigma means summation. So that if you had three values, let's say 0, 1, and 2, you would say 0 times the probability of that, 1 times the probability of that, and 2 times the probability of that, and you would add those three values together, and you would get the mean. And it is a population, so we're talking about mu and lowercase sigma for the mean and standard deviation there, because we're talking about our distribution includes all the possible outcomes. And just be careful about rounding. Your website or your instructor will have specific information about where to round, so be looking for that too. All right, identifying unusual results using the range rule of thumb. According to the range rule of thumb, most values should lie within two standard deviations of the mean. Unusual values lie outside these limits. So if you take the mean and add two standard deviations, you get the max value. And if you take the mean and subtract two standard deviations, you get the minimum usual value. Not the maximum possible, but the maximum and minimum usual values, the ones that we would most likely see. The rare rule for inferential statistics says that if under a given assumption, the probability of a particular observed event is very small, we conclude that the assumption is probably false. We have a given assumption, and then we see something happen, and we say, oh, we probably were wrong. For an example, assuming that we have a fair coin, then getting heads 992 times in 1,000 tosses of a coin. The probability of getting 992 heads in 1,000 is rare. So we must assume that our assumption is false and the coin is not fair. So if we see something that has a really small probability, and then we start to say, whoa, something's happening here. So it's the rare rule. Okay, let's take a look at this one. Given the information in the range, use the range rule of thumb to find the range of values that are not significant. That is, they are the usual values. We want to know what's our maximum usual and what's our minimum usual. And we have this right here. So if you were in StatCrunch, you could use your StatCrunch to find the mean and the standard deviation, which is what I did. But I put the formula here too, so you can see how that number is derived. So the mean is 4.003 for this probability distribution that's talking about the number of boys and the probability of getting 0 boys, 1 boy, 2 boys, so forth, and 8 births. And then the standard deviation is 1.412. The maximum usual value is the mean plus two standard deviations, and that was 6.827. And the minimum usual value was the mean minus two standard deviations, and that was 1.179. So you can see if you look at it as a normal distribution here, we would say that 95% of our values lie here between 1.179 and 6.827. That makes that the cutoff for the usual values. From the information above, we can see that the usual number of boys would be from 1.2 to 6.8, depending on where you round it. Is 2 boys and 8 births a significantly low number of boys? 2 would be here, because anything to the left of this is less than 1.179. So that's not unusual. 2 would not be unusual, so not significantly unusual. It's on the low side, but it's not significantly unusual. You can see that this happens 11.9%, and we would actually be looking at all these, adding all three of those together to say if 2 was unusual, and so it's not less than 5%. Is 7 boys and 8 a significantly high number? Well, here's our cutoff, 6.8, so 7 is to the right of that, so it would be a significantly high number of boys if you had 7 out of 8. Okay, And then when you look at identifying unusual and usual probabilities, I was just referring to that 5%, because 95% is usual. Anything less than 5% of the time is considered unusual. And notice we have X is more or X is fewer. We're always talking about a range, not a single value when we're asking those things. And I want you to know that probability relates to area. So the area under the curve has a total of 1. Probability goes from 0 to 100. But when we look at a percent of a normal distribution, we remember that if we have we're 0 standard deviations away, that's the mean, right? And if the standard deviation is 1.4, then 4 plus 1.4 means at one standard deviation, we'd be at 5.4. Or negative 1, we'd be at 2.6, so we're subtracting, right? So the usual range of values go from 1.2 up to 6.8. And that means everything in here is considered usual value. And we can talk about it as a percentage as 95.2%, but we could talk about it as the area under the curve. It's 0.952 out of 1 and the area under the curve, right? So area and probability relate. So we can see, most of that area is shaded when we are talking about A, B, C, and D, right? And remember, if we want to know if a particular value is significantly high or significantly low, we're looking at that value or fewer or that value or more, like we saw here. So here's an example. Use the given information to find the probability of having exactly 7 boys. Find the probability of having 7 or more boys. And which is the relevant probability to answer this question? Is having 7 boys and 8 births a significantly high number? Well, here's our distribution. We know it adds up to 1. The probability of 7 is right here, 0.026. The probability of having 7 or more, we would just add these two probabilities together, because 7 or 8 would be 7 or more, and that's 0.031. The relevant probability to answer the question is the probability greater than or equal to 7? 7 or more is the relevant probability to answer the question, is 7 significant? Notice that the sum of the probabilities for having 7 or 8 boys is below our 5% threshold, or our 0.05 threshold. It's 0.031. Since that number is less than 0.05, then we would say that having 7 boys and 8 births is significantly high, because the probability of that is less than 0.05. All right, have a fantastic day, and we'll see you next time.